Today I'm going to attempt to introduce you to our winemaking philosophy and our whole stylistic approach as to our wines, varietals. Really, I think in today's world, it really evolves around a clear understanding of what a vineyard can give. So we really embrace a lot of teamwork, and in our case, we're fortunate to have an above average viticultural team and winemaking team that work together to achieve our stylistic approaches. Now, having said that, it probably takes a good 10 years to fully understand the vineyard site. That even before you can attempt to look at a winemaking policy. And if you're really serious about what you're doing, you would then probably have to be trialing that wine for another 10 years. Now, most people will say you must be crazy because that's half your working life, but I think in the world of wine, a span of 20 years is really not much. And if you didn't do it, you wouldn't really know what the logical conclusion was. So having said that, I've always been very keen on wines that were coming from cooler growing regions. And that was maybe also triggered, let's say, where the enjoyment came from was really from enjoying European wines, where I, as a young winemaker, obviously was exposed to. Secondly, I think the important thing is that for many winemakers worldwide, our inspiration is still drawn from old Europe. And even they, from time to time, have to sort of reinvent where they came to and where they've come from. And secondly, I think the evolution of wine styles has sort of somewhat seen a 360. So there's many producers who are really looking, let's call it the classic styles, although there's wonderful attempts if we look at what one could refer to as alternate wine styles. We've obviously opted for the route of going classic, wines that have wonderful purity of fruit, that are really expressive of the variety and its region. And obviously this is achieved through, as I've alluded to, good viticultural practices, and secondly, winemaking practices where there's a lot of attention to detail. And if we look at the styles and the varietals we work with, yeah, these are wines that I think would meet international standards and international approval, and I think have a track record of doing exactly that. The two varieties are two main varieties when it comes to whites, Sauvignon Blanc. And our focus is on Sauvignon Blanc that is grown in the clinical ward that's near the town of Darling. And we also have Sauvignon Blanc coming from Elgin. Now, I mean, Elgin, as most people might know, I think has enjoyed a history of the citrus fruit. But in the late 80s, early 90s, there was a lot of pioneering work done on viticulture coming from that area, and I think today we see wonderful examples of it. Our Chardonnay is, we have also interest in Chardonnay from that region. But getting back to Kroonekloof, that's by contrast a vineyard position on the west coast of the Cape. It's about 80 kilometers up the coastline from Cape Town. And the distinctiveness of that growing region is that there's a series of hills that runs parallel to the coastline. We're on the most south-facing aspects of those hills, and ranges from about 120 going up to 370 meters above sea level. So this really affords you quite a wide picking window. The other thing that might hold interest is that we've purposely at this stage left all our cultivation to what we refer to as a bush vine. And you must remember that region enjoys no supplementary irrigation, so we're relying entirely on dry land farming. And bush vines are really ideally suited to that way of farming. We also, I think, are in a fortunate position that we have a reasonable amount of knowledge of what's going on in that region. So we've been in and about it for the last 30 years. And it's that, I think, that kind of experience that I'm very privileged to be able to slowly pass over to Warren. My son is now really taking charge of winemaking and viticulture. And if I may add, I think he has a wonderful touch too. Getting back to our Chard base coming from Elgin, these are wines that show far more elegance, far more restraint. We are very careful with the amount of oaking, so always there's a big emphasis on well-judged oaking other than obtrusive oaking. And these old wines are also, I think, portray wonderful food flavors. So typically from that region, you would be touching on aromatics that sort of more revolve around subtle citrus flavors. So there'd be subtle notes of limes, lemons, hints of green melon. But it's really on the palate that we put a big focus on mouthfeel and texture. And obviously that style of wine, I also believe, is far more in keeping with international standards and trends other than being very showy, which I can admire but seldom drink. The majority of our reds are obviously farmed in and around Stellenbosch, and we have a big emphasis on Cabernet Franc, Merlot, Pinot Grigio, Pinotage. These are, in terms of their stylistic designs, far more at home, and also it gives us food to work with and be comfortable with. But I mean, really, if you're looking at Cabernet from Stellenbosch, it's arguably one of the places in the world that has the ability to deliver really wonderful wines that can hold their own in any international country. Our wine is positioned in Stellenbosch, and so obviously we bring all our fruit in from Kroonekloof, from Elgin, from the Pekingese Kloof. And all this is made in the winery in Stellenbosch. And for us, it's a relatively new facility. We completed the building in 2010, but 2015 was really the first time that we did all our winemaking under one roof. And I must say, it's the